this is Travis. We're going to go over Bittensor subnet number 3, named Templar. I have no association with the subnet, but I think what they're building is pretty cool. So right now, we rely on massive centralized data centers to train AI. This, of course, limits who can train AI and limits the scalability of that training. It also wastes a lot of global compute potential. What if we could train on an infinitely scalable number of diverse computers across the world? This is Subnet 3 Templar's vision. Typically, training an AI requires a large coordinated data center, requiring a massive investment. In a centralized training environment, developers collect a massive data set and then use that massive data set to train the AI. Doing this requires thousands of powerful GPUs pooling their resources together to train against the massive data set. With Subnet 3, Templar, we still have thousands of powerful GPUs pooling their resources together, but the subnet splits the training data set between them. So each miner gets a portion of the training data set, referred to as a page, and they train against that. They provide gradients. Gradients are essentially a compass that points in the direction of making the AI smarter. And then every so often, these gradients are synchronized between all miners and combined. Miners then train against that synchronized model, produce gradients. Those gradients are eventually synchronized, etc., over and over again, constantly improving the model in each sync. This represents a big leap forward in decentralized training. With Subnet 3, all compute power adds to the total, creating a scalable decentralized training solution. Let's go over the incentive mechanism, or how miners are evaluated. First, they must be synchronized with a network. If a miner falls too behind, its score will drop. Miners are rewarded based on their loss improvement. Loss is a metric for measuring how smart an AI is, the lower the better. Miners who are able to reduce the loss quicker are rewarded more. And then there's overfitting. Overfitting happens when an AI learns a dataset's specific details too well, making it struggle with new and different data. So miners who overfit are given lower scores. And then, of course, these incentives are constantly being updated and refined with a goal of having miners produce the most value. The subnet owner can also add new incentives when needed as well. So miners from anywhere and everywhere in the world compete to improve the model that they're training. Miners that improve it the most are rewarded the most. And the thing that makes Subnet 3 special is that miners don't duplicate each other's work. At the time of this recording, top miners in the subnet are making approximately $9,000 per day from emissions, or 250 Subnet 3 alpha. This, of course, will fluctuate. See the current price by visiting the links in the description. Currently, miners need at least one H100 GPU with good internet bandwidth. They should also have expertise in AI training and distributed computing to be able to scale up to multiple machines and have a shot at that $9,000 per day. Templar has a very aggressive roadmap. They're focused on progressively training larger state-of-the-art models. Right now, they're training a 1.2 billion parameter model. Next is an 8 billion parameter model. And they have their sights on a 70 billion parameter model and beyond. They want to expand to other areas of training, like mid-training and post-training. Eventually, they see Templar as the best platform in the world for training models, where frontier teams will acquire Subnet 3 alpha tokens to train models using Templar. They are also considering the idea of token gating the models produced on Templar, making those models only accessible to Subnet 3 alpha token holders. If you're interested in using the subnet to train your model, you can follow their Twitter or X for updates as to when this will become available. If you're interested in competing to provide compute to the subnet as a miner, you can watch my miner course or join the Bittensor Discord and find Subnet 3 or jump straight into the GitHub. Links to the subnet's GitHub, X, dashboard, etc. are all in the description. In Bittensor, things move very quickly. Everything in this video is surely out of date by the time you're watching it, so you can visit tao.app or learnbittensor.org to get the latest information. If this sounds interesting, but you have no idea what I'm talking about with all the Bittensor-related jargon, feel free to watch the playlist in the description that will help you get up to speed very quickly, or visit learnbittensor.org.